So Samsung may be forced to discontinue the A series. To be honest, after seeing the Geekbench performance, I'm starting to doubt Samsung's entire chip strategy. Let me explain. Just so you know, this breakdown is based on the chip's initial scores, but it still counts as the price we pay for the A series phones. Samsung's upcoming Exynos 1680 chip has been spotted on Geekbench, and the numbers tells an interesting story. This chip is expected to power the Galaxy A57 5G. But here is the thing, the performance figures are raising some serious questions. The new Exynos 1680 comes with the 8 cores, but they run at much lower speeds. Main core just 2 GHz compared to 2.9 GHz on the older 1580. Performance scores 1.9 GHz versus 2.6 GHz on the old chip. Even the efficiency core got slower. Now Samsung claims this chip has 2x better gaming performance, and sure, they upgraded from XClip 540 to XClip 550 GPU. It uses the same RDNA 3.5 tech as their flagship Exynos 2500. But here is what they don't want you to know. In actual benchmark, it scored 6,330 points, while the older 1580 scored 6,865 points. Now that's going backwards, not forward. Think about it, when people buy an upper mid-range Samsung phone with an Exynos chip, they often get weaker gaming performance, battery drain issues, heat problems, overall slower experience compared to the Snapdragon versions. Look guys, I have been saying this for years, Samsung need to ditch Exynos in the mid-range phones. I get it, Exynos saves them money because it's their own chip, but here is the reality check they need. They are losing fans left and right because of this underwhelming performance. You know what Samsung should do? Go with MediaTek Dimensity chips. And before you say, but MediaTek is not good, hold up, Samsung already proved this works perfectly with their Galaxy Tab series. Those tablets are running Dimensity chips and they are absolutely crushing it in performance and efficiency. MediaTek's Dimensity lineup has gotten so good in recent years, better power efficiency, solid gaming performance, and way more reliable than these confusing Exynos chips that sometimes works great, sometimes don't. Samsung, if you are listening, your fans want reliability. They want performance they can count on. Stop trying to save a few dollars per phone when it's costing you your reputation in the mid-range market. What do you guys think? Should Samsung finally move away from the Exynos in its A-series phones? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. And if you want more honest tech talks like this, smash that like button and ring the notification bell. Until next time, this is TechStream, keeping it real in the tech world.